Melissa Armel is here with us, and we will be starting promptly in just 2 minutes. You see the fireworks slide there. Looks like fireworks over New York, and maybe not. No, it's probably New York, and that's. Actually, we have a lot of people still joining, okay? And we're going to be starting promptly in just 2 minutes. JQ Public was the last person to join in. Before that, KW, Quick Fingers, Luke. Joe is here with us. This is online at Trader Central. Thank you, everyone, and welcome. It is New York. It is New York. Okay, all right. Fireworks over New York, everyone. Thank you so much and welcome. This is Online Trader Central. Start time in just about 1 minute. We have folks still registering. Thank you for being here on time. We do appreciate each and every one of you. Rack just joined us. We are fortunate that everyone is here on time, and we'll be starting promptly at 5:30 Eastern time, which is in just about a minute. So again, we thank, Don R. just joined us. Again, this is Online Trader Central. We appreciate each and every one of you. We especially are, JL just joined us. So the presentation is scheduled to start, and I'll bring on the, let's do this. Okay, here we go. Drummers, are you ready? All right, and cue the trumpet. And with that, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much. Please put your hands together and welcome our host and presenter today from the StockSwish.com.
Thank you so much, Kevin. Thank you, everyone at Online Trader Central, and welcome. My name is Melissa Armo. You'll have to bear with me here today. I don't sound like myself. If you've been following me for a while, I have a cold I've been fighting, but I'm finally starting to feel a little bit better today. And I'm lucky to be here with you, and you're lucky to be here with me. I'm going to talk today about the strategy that I trade, and it's really a common sense strategy. One of the things that I like about trading is that I can trade very early in the morning and be in and out of my trades very quickly. And so we're also going to talk about that too. And Kevin was mentioning the fireworks. Yes, this is actually a picture that I took from my phone. This was the Lunar New Year. It was a beautiful fireworks display. It went on for about an hour. And this is the Hudson River. That's New Jersey. And this is the view from my bedroom window. So it's spectacular. And Paul was nice enough to put it in the webinar. So if you want more information, you can email me at melissa@thestockswish.com. Kathy's going to put her information in there. But today we're going to talk about making $100,000 a year trading 30 minutes a day using common sense. Common sense meaning a common sense strategy, which is what I do. So again, if you'd like more information, you can email me here and you can feel free to give me a call. And hopefully as the week goes on, my voice will improve. So if you also would like more information about testimonials from some of my traders, you can go to this website or you can email me and I can give you some referrals to talk to people that have done my class. Mike has a nice video here. I did a trader interview with him about a week ago, and you can go to my YouTube site and subscribe there and watch the trader interview with Mike and also some other webinars that I have posted as well. So let's get started. If you're a busy person and you don't have a lot of time but want to make extra money or thinking about transitioning careers, you know, trading my method, my strategy might be something you want to look into. A lot of people are doing different things with their lives. They have juggling career, family, home, and they want to make extra money, and they don't have, you know, time to devote another 20, 30 hours a week to a part-time job. The nice thing about day trading is that you can do it in the morning in 30 minutes a day, 1 hour a day, 30 minutes prep time, you know, 30 minutes while you trade, and get on with your day. So the nice thing about day trading is that you don't have to give up your full-time job if you want to do it. And it can be a nice way to transition into a full-time income or a full-time job to get to the point where you quit your day job. And if you're tired of your career, then you might be one of these people that wants to start thinking about transitioning. And all of this is a process. It's not something that you just wake up one morning and say, boom, you know, I'm an immediate trader. Everything in life is a process. There's a learning curve that goes on with learning. And I run a live trading room, which I'll talk about later, for people to just take my trades. I call the trades in the room daily and people just take my trades. And it's a very easy way for people to make money in the market after they do my class. If you don't want to work for yourself for the rest of your life and you want to be more self-sufficient, then day trading certainly can offer that. The thing is that a lot of people just don't know how to trade the market. And I get emails from people all the time, and I get questions on YouTube and Facebook, and people ask me questions about stocks. And the very first thing I say is, what is the strategy? Why did you take this trade, or why are you doing this trade? If you've never tried trading in the past and you've thought about it and you need to know where to start, then a good place is a foundation. And the foundation really is a structure and a system that can tell you what stock every day to trade and in what direction to trade it. And I see some people just signing in. Forgive me, my voice does not sound like this at all normally. I'm a very, very enthusiastic person, but right now I'm fighting a cold. But hopefully everyone can still hear me clearly. And if you have questions, you can write it in there and I will answer the questions. If you're trading right now and you don't have a strategy, or you have one but it doesn't make you good enough money, again, maybe this is something you want to think about. Maybe you want to learn something new. I'm a firm believer that if you're doing something that makes money in the market, just keep doing it. If you have a strategy right now that's profitable and you're doing well, just continue on with it. Increase your size and make more money. But a lot of people are doing things that are not profitable and they keep doing them. So the idea is to make money. That's the reason that you trade. That's the reason you do it, whether it's for a full-time income like making six figures a year or a part-time income. It's something where you want to be profitable. Otherwise, you're just kind of batting your head against the wall. And many, many people are doing this. They're batting their head against the wall. They don't have a strategy. They don't have any direction in the trading. And I'm very focused on what I do every day. In fact, I already know what I'm trading tomorrow. I looked at some stocks that are gapping tonight, and I already know what I'm going to do tomorrow. How amazing is that? To know exactly what you're going to trade, you know, almost a day ahead of time. And this is the focus for me. This is where the focus lies. So what strategy can you trade and make money daily in 30 minutes? It's golden gaps. It's something that I created. I termed it golden gaps, or I coined the term golden gaps, but it is a method that I use to determine what gap to trade each day in the market. I prefer to short. For those of you that know me, you know I like to short, and if you've never heard of me before, and this is your first time here, I found that shorting happens and the momentum comes into stocks when selling action happens very quickly into the open between 9:30 and 10. So this 30-minute period that I focus on is between 9:30 and 10 a.m. and you get a lot of momentum that comes, boom, right into the trade, right into the stock. And we're going to go over some of those trades here today. Now, for those of you that are brand new, if you don't know what a gap is, I'm going to just show you here. This is a review, then you just have to listen. A gap is a break between prices on a chart that occurs when the price of a stock moves a sharp move up or down with no trading occurring in between. It's the difference between the close and open. So this is a 1 minute chart. Okay. So right up here, you have the stock closed the night before. This is at 4 o'clock, and here is 9:30 where the stock opened the next day. Now this was Starbucks from last week. This was an earnings report that happened that created the gap. So the stock closed up here at around 60 some dollars and opened down here around 59 something. So this is different from this, where it closed is different from the open. And again, there are stocks that gapped down, or this could have gapped up. Starbucks could have gapped up to $75. It didn't, but it could have. Okay. So that's what a gap is. But like I said, I prefer the downside moves. I prefer to short. And so this is another example of a gap. This is MYL. This is a daily chart. So before we were looking at the 1 minute, this is the daily. See here where the stock closed the day before, and then it gapped down. So closed here at one price. It was like around 48 something or whatever. Then it gapped down here to like 46 and change. Okay. So the stock closed at one price and opened another price. And here's what it did in the live day. And it fell. This red bar here depicts selling action. And so what I do to make the money is to look to find which stock symbol, in this one here, it was MYL, you look to find the one you're going to do each day to make money. And then you're trying to find a trade set up in that 30-minute period to take it to make money. And that's really all that you need. To train all day from 9:30 to 4 o'clock, what many, many people do is they just end up giving money back to the market, or they chop themselves up in commissions, and they're back and forth with wins and losses. I make my life very easy by focusing on the morning time period. And so this was a good one here. And this was Paul's trade, and he's going to go over that today. But gaps are a strategy that's set up in the market on a daily basis. Every day you're looking for something different. Every day I get up, I never know what stock I'm going to trade. Every once in a while I do the market. But gaps are a strategy that's set up daily, and they provide moves that happen quickly in the morning, and they usually finish very quickly. Now, that's not to say that you can't hold some of these moves into swing trades or longer-term trades, but I prefer to do the day trades. And many gap trades set up and are done in the first half hour of the trading day. And you usually get 75 to 80% of the full day's move within the 30 minutes. And the reason for that is because institutions like banks and hedge funds sell positions into the open. Their traders have the positions ready pre-market to sell into the open. And gaps happen, like I said, on a regular basis with momentum. And momentum meaning to me is something that moves $1, $2, $3. And I'm not talking about very expensive stocks like Amazon or Google. Those stocks move, you know, $15, $20 on a day, on a normal day. I'm talking about average stocks between about a $5 price point and $65. I'm looking for a range of $1 to $3, $4 move, depending on the price point. Now, KW has a question here. Only stocks and not futures. Yes, I only trade stocks. And we're gonna look at Starbucks here, which I did on Friday, which was just a perfect example of what I do so well as a day trader, which I'll talk about in a little bit here in the chart. But, you know, when you think about Starbucks, something comes to mind, the company. You think, oh, my, the coffee you love, the latte you like to drink, the pumpkin spice I like in the fall, whatever. You think of something you like, or maybe there's something you hate about Starbucks. Maybe you don't like something about Starbucks. Maybe you don't like the expensive some of the expensive coffees. Maybe you don't like the line at Starbucks. Whatever, you have an emotion that goes with the Starbucks. There's no emotions that go with futures. Do you understand the difference, KW? So when you are trading as a person and you are looking to make money as an individual trader, and you are doing this with a fixed amount of money, okay, whatever that fixed amount of money is, whether you have $5,000 or $50,000, you need to take advantage of momentum volatility. And so there's a lot of volatility that happens on a more regular basis in companies because emotions are high in companies, whether those are positive emotions or negative emotions. And so that allows for more play, and that allows for more opportunity for you as a day trader to make money. Does that make sense? Hopefully that answers KW's question. And anybody else that answers the question, I'll just repeat it out loud. Okay. So as I was saying, trading is a serious business. Trading is a skill, actually. And it's a skill that can be mastered. But you've got to get one specific strategy down to do it. And like I said, I focus on gaps. To me, it's really not a function of luck in the market. I expect every day to get up and have a series of gaps to look at. Will I get a good one or not that meets my criteria? I never know. Usually I do. But it's a function of my own skill to be able to look at 50 stocks that are gapping and then pick the two perfect ones to do. That isn't luck, because there's too many stocks out there, too many ticker symbols, too many things gapping down and up and all over the place, and you have to know which ones to do. And also, 30 minutes, you know, sounds like a long time, but actually, if you're not watching the right stock at the right time, you might miss it. What if it goes without you? If you don't find it on your scanner till 10 o'clock, 10, 15, the whole move may be done. So you've got to learn the right method and skills. And if you do this, you can create your own luck. And I certainly have done this. I taught myself my own method, and now I'm teaching other people. And here I am, you know, 8 years later. So it's one of these things, the better you get at something, the better you do. The equity curve of traders is supposed to increase over time. Now, you might You might take 10 steps forward and 3 steps back, or 5 steps forward and 2 steps back, but you're supposed to be going higher, and most people are not. And I found that it is because they just don't have the right strategy, or they don't have the right focus, or they don't take it seriously enough. You know, sometimes people say, well, I'm only taking 100, 200 shares. Well, it's still a trade. It's still money. You have to still take it seriously. Whether you're taking 2,000 shares or 200 shares, you need to take it seriously. And some people do take it seriously. I mean, I've talked to a lot of people since I've had the business. Some take it seriously, but they just are not consistent. And the lack of consistency really is due to the lack of focus on the right strategy. So why do gaps work so fast? Because of the sense of urgency. And the sense of urgency comes into the open in for shorts, okay, like for the Starbucks, it's a panic. And I'll explain why in the chart in a minute. For people that are going long, if the stock gaps up, okay, it's more like, oh my gosh, you know, I don't want to miss this. I better buy it now. If I don't buy it now, I won't get a good price, that kind of thing. In fact, if anyone wants to look at anything that's gapping up tonight, I can look at it. I don't know if anything is, but I saw some down gaps. But either way, something has to be done when the gap occurs. It's forcing people to make a decision. Either they have to sell out of the position or they will rush to buy it into the open. And again, this is how people think and feel, and it's the reaction. And that's why you get more play in stocks. And this is why you get play in gaps. And it's, to me, it's the only thing that I do, because I feel like it's the only thing that really offers the high level of profitability and consistency as an individual day trader. A lot of day traders get chopped up back and forth because they don't know what to do and they're waiting till 10 o'clock. Well, often I'm in and out of my trades in 5-10 minutes and I'm done. And I try to be done by 10 o'clock every day. But gaps are made by institutional money. I mean banks and hedge funds that buy or sell stocks. Now, KW is asking another question here. What tools do you use to find stocks that gap? I just have the top 20 down list in my platform. That's it. I don't have an extra scanner. If you want to buy a scanner, you can buy a scanner, but I don't have an extra scanner. I just use the top 20 list of downs and ups, so you have 40 stocks in each of the exchanges, in the NASDAQ and the New York Exchange. Okay? And that should come with any of your platforms that you pay for. So let's take a look here at Microsoft. This was Friday, okay? So Microsoft, well, it was Thursday night, actually. Microsoft had earnings. Google and Microsoft had earnings, and they both gapped down. This was Thursday night. So Thursday into the close, Microsoft closed here around 55-something, and then it had earnings. And Thursday night, it gapped down, and Friday morning, look where it opened. So this is the panic action, people. Do you see this here? So the stock closes here at 55-something, and it opens $3 lower. That's panic. Now, who was panicking? Who were the panicky people? Well, the people that own the stock, okay? If you own the stock, okay, and you were up in it at this price, and you get out of bed, and it's at this price, you are in panic mode. Now, you might be down completely, or you might actually be up money still, but not up as much, but you're still will be panicking, okay? So this panic action creates a sell-off. Now, you cannot short every gap down. There's probably some gap downs in here I can show you. Oh, let me look here. This was a gap down here, dropped, got bought. This was a gap down here, stock closed here, gap down, got bought. Here was another gap down here, got bought. So you can't short every gap down, okay? But every one that you find, you can look at and evaluate. And this is what I do, okay? And again, you can look at up gaps. So this was Microsoft over here. This was the previous earnings. It closed here and gapped up. This was last quarter. This is second quarter here in April. This is last quarter here in February. The stock had gapped up. You could have bought it that day. This day was a short, which was Friday. And there it is. So here was the trade. The 1 minute chart is here. So this is what I look to trade on. So you want to make the money, and you want to make the money in that first 30 minute period. And you're wanting to make, you know, six figures a year, and you can make way more than that trading when you get good. But the idea is to start out from one vantage point. The vantage point is you find first Microsoft. You determine if this is a short or a long. And I'll explain this in a little bit here, which is my system. But if you determine it's a good short, then you're going to watch it at 9:30. You don't do anything before the pre-market. Okay. So the stock closed up here last night, or this was Thursday night. Friday morning it opens. Stock opens. This is actually, it opened here with a doji-like bar. You can't see it because of the line. But then it rallied. And you can short it. And so I short the stock. You put the stop in, and it drops. And so here's the stock falling. So you can see here where it's around $52, and it dropped and broke, actually $51. So this, okay, is happening here between when? This is around 9:30 to 9:33 in the morning. Stock drops, and you see it falls right into the first 30-minute period. It actually just bled lower. So this is the kind of thing that you are looking for every day if you come and trade with me, and you just see it and you do it. So the entry of this was 52.17. Price of the stop was 52.40. So I take a trade, I short something, and then I put the stop in. It's a limit order stop. So for example, if the stock would have gone over this number, then I would have been stopped out, okay? The risk in this case is 23 cents. It's a difference between the price and the stop. Now I'm using, I risk more than this per trade, but I used all the trades in here. I used what you would risk if you wanted to make 100 grand a year, just so you know. So if you want to risk $460, that would be 2,000 shares in Microsoft. Now this was my exit. I didn't hold it all the way down to the low of the day. The low of the day was 50.77, which was great. But I got out here, 51.18. So if you risked $460, you could have made $1,980. That's fantastic. And to be honest with you, you could have taken the trade here and just never looked back. I mean, this is one of the reasons why I love to day trade. And whether you want to do this full time or part time, it doesn't even matter. To be able to make this kind of money in 30 minutes is just phenomenal to me. I don't think it will ever not be phenomenal to me because I meet up with so many different people from so many walks of life. All my friends have regular jobs. They go to their job and they take the subway to the job and they work 10-hour days in the city. And, you know, they do not make thousands of dollars in minutes. So this is one of these things that you really, you know, if you take the time to learn how to do it, can really, really pay off for you in the long run because it's a phenomenal way to earn a living. But if you have another job you like, you can keep that and just make extra money on the side trading. The risk reward in this trade, there was 4.3 times the risk made in profit. And this is a solid trade. Okay, now I have a couple questions here. Is an options put? You can do a put in this if you want. No, this, I'm equity trading. I'm actually taking the actual equity trade here, Joe. You can do a put if you want to. That's another way to do it. You can do that as well. You can use my method for trading options. I actually have started doing options myself in the last year, end of 2015. But daily, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, I'm day trading the equity straight. And a few times a month, I'll do options. But usually on expensive stocks, I'll do options. This to me is not an expensive stock. But you could do that. And yes, you could. And you could day trade it too. Gus is saying, you can find stocks that gap every day or early in earnings season. No, you can find stocks that gap every day. There's also stocks that have news gaps. Somebody goes on TV and somebody says something. All of a sudden, the stock gaps. I mean, anything could happen. A CEO could talk. Cramer could talk on his television show. There's lots of reasons why things gap. But in earnings season, you get a lot of them. And so right now, it's second quarter earnings season. So there's just a lot of things to look at. And when you have a lot of things to trade, guess what? You have a lot of opportunity to make money. Now, I put this in here because this is, as I was talking about my friends, this really puts it into perspective. When you break it down and you look and you say, okay, you know, almost $2,000 in 30 minutes. And you look at it, you say, okay, that's a lot of money. Your hourly pay comes out to be like $1,326 an hour. You know, that's amazing. Okay, that's really, really good. And this includes the prep time. not everybody comes into the trading room an hour ahead of time. I do. But I'm just saying, you know, if you want to do this, you should prep and start in the room at least around 9 a.m. Market opens at 9:30. Some people start about 8:39, come in the room with me, and they're there till 10. You really got to be there between 9:30 and 10 there to get the trades. But if you look at this, you say, gosh, you know, my pay rate is about $1,000 an hour. And you say, that's really good, Melissa. And when I compare myself to the other jobs, the careers, the people that I know have, it really puts it into perspective for me. Now, it took work for me to get here, obviously, and it takes work for other people to get to this point where they learn how to do it, like taking my class. But in the end, it's worth it because you could work your whole life and never find a job where you average $1,000 an hour. And KW has another question here. Do you need a minimum of $25,000 account? KW, I can email you referrals to brokers. There are a lot of places to trade. There are proprietary day trading firms out there where you don't need $25,000. There are retail firms which you need $25,000 to actively day trade. And then there are places that are retail firms where you can do options where you don't need $25,000 and you can implement my system using options. So you have to call a broker. I'm not a broker for that, but I can certainly refer you to some. But there's proprietary day trading firms out there that do not require $25,000, okay? Now, does anyone have any questions so far about anything I'm saying? The bottom line is, the gist of what I'm trying to say is that in order to get to the point of making six figures a year, you've got to have a strategy. Whether your goal is for full-time, part-time, retirement, if you don't have a strategy, you're never even going to make it past, you know, 6 months or 1 year of doing this. Lasting success means you learn something that you can replicate for as long as you live in the market. And I truly believe that I'll be trading gaps, you know, as my strategy and nothing else for forever. And the people that I've taught are such believers that that's the case as well. And a lot of my traders are doing swing trades and options now too. Every trader needs a strategy. It has to be real. It has to be good. It has to make sense. And the common sense goes to what I was saying. If you have panic coming into a stock like Microsoft from an earnings, then common sense says, what do you think people will do? Okay. And again, the emotions are more in stocks than futures. And emotions are more in stocks than even something like Forex. Forex is so popular now for people to trade. You can't apply my method to that because Forex only has one gap a week. I mean, you could, I guess, but you'd only be using it one gap a week. But everyone is so excited about this Forex, mainly because the leverage is so high, but you don't have the same emotions riding high with it. And it's an unregulated market. The beauty about the U.S. stock market is that it does have some regulation, which protects you as a consumer and as an individual. And you also have an open and a close. And I like that. It actually keeps me very structured and disciplined. Paul, you can email me that after the webinar. I can send that to you. Gus, you can email me. I can recommend some platforms too. Rock is asking me a question. If the trade does not work, do you jump onto another trade or do you focus only on one trade a day? Well, it depends. It depends. For example, Rack, what if I get up in the morning and I only have the Microsoft? And if Microsoft would have failed, which it didn't, then I wouldn't have done anything else. I would have had to take the loss in the Microsoft. What if I get up in the morning and I have Microsoft and Starbucks? If I had done the Microsoft and Microsoft failed, then I could have done the Starbucks if it rated well per my system, and then I would have done Starbucks and then I would have made money. As it turns out, Friday, I did do both and they both worked and I made money in both of them. So some days, what if you don't get two gaps? What if you only get one good one, Rack? You know what I'm saying? I have a specific criteria. It's a checklist that I look for to determine what gap to do. And that's how I know. And I must tell you that I don't take a lot of trades. I just don't. I'm not a broker's dream in the sense that I run up commissions, but I will tell you I'm a broker's dream in the sense that I have longevity. You know, I've been at the same place trading now almost the entire time I've traded. Actually, I left at one point, went to a prop place, and ended up coming back to the place that I was at before, the retail account, and I'll probably never leave there. You really just, you know, a lot of brokers have people that churn and burn places. And quite honestly, educational places have people that churn and burn places too. You cannot join my trading room without actually taking my class. It's a benchmark. It's a benchmark that costs money to take the course and invest your time and energy into doing it. I often have people that come and say, Melissa, I've been training for 20 years. I just want to join your room. And I say, no, I'm sorry. It doesn't matter to me if you've been training for 120 years. You don't know what I do. And it's about the commitment level and the longevity and the consistency. So when you go out and you decide, hey, I want to do this thing and I really want to be successful, there's a level of commitment there. The level of commitment for you is that you are going to learn it. It's going to make sense. You're going to comprehend it. You're not going to just do it because I say it. Common sense means you should be able to understand it. I should be able to understand it. I should be able to go and explain it to a guy on the street and he should be able to understand it. I should be able to explain it to my niece, who actually is her birthday today. She just turned 12, and have her understand it. And she probably would if I sat down and told her. People have to get this, and it's common sense to me. But common sense says you need an event in order for stock to move and have a lot of volatility. You've got to have that. Now, whether it's a bullish event or a bearish event, you don't know until it happens. But to decide what stock to trade, you begin with the one simple concept, the one simple idea, which is the event. This event is a reactionary change, which is, guess what? It's the gap. Okay, this is what I'm talking about. The gap is the event. You don't know, though, whether you're going to go long or short it until you rate it. So a gap is a strategy you would use to enter or exit a trade. And this is what I do. It's a reactionary event. And this was a reactionary event, and it created a sell-off here. This is the Starbucks. We're going to go over this, but we talked about this earlier. It's a one-minute chart, and it forces people to take action in the stock. And when people take action, you're going to have play in it. I say play in it, but it means it's going to move, okay? You know what? I love trading, and I love stocks that move, but I don't trade penny stocks, and I hate to trade stocks that don't move at all. I don't trade stocks that are low volume. You know, I like stuff that moves. I want it to go, you know, and I want it to go quickly. And so you have stocks that have events, and the event is the gap. And it's because of the shock. The shock happens and comes in. And the power is the money. Now, the money could be selling, or the money could be buying. Okay? Now, we kind of were talking about this before. Here's a Starbucks. Okay, Gus has another question here. Let me just quickly ask. How long are students staying in the trading room after the training? I'd say that really varies, Gus. To be honest with you, that's a good question. I should go back and track it or take a poll in the room tomorrow. Honestly, I have people that have been with me for years that don't have to be there. They don't have to be there at all. I would say 75% of the room has been with me for more than 12 months. They don't need to be there, but they like being in the room. They like hearing me lecture. They like learning. I just make it easy for them. Then there's about 25-30% of the people that are new, that just did the class, that want to get going. They come into the room after the class. They get ramped up. They go out and off on their own. And then every once in a while, I get a person that I haven't heard from for a while that wants to come back to the room. And actually just heard from one of those people today. He's coming back for May. So, you know, most of the people are there don't need to be. But I would say a lot of people are off on their own. And they come at the beginning, maybe for 2-3 months. And then they go off on their own. But sometimes they come back. You know, you get to the point where sometimes, like, to be honest with you, probably the last month, people were like, thought the market was choppy. To me, the market was always higher and is higher. But, you know, I think that if you don't have someone directing you every day, and you could get off track. The idea is to stay very focused. Now, I'm a very organized individual. I'm very analytical. I can be very focused myself in my trading. If you have trouble with that, then you want to be in the room, okay? So everybody's personality is different. Gus is saying, can you stay? You can, once you take the class, the class. You can retake the class as many times for free after you take it, and then you're a Golden Gap student. So if you want to take the class, then you're a Golden Gap student. You're eligible to join the room at any point forever, Gus. Okay? Or email me questions or retake the class. Okay, let's talk about Starbucks. So here, the Starbucks closed the night before and Gap down here. Now, again, this was Friday, too. I ended up doing them both. It was a busy morning. But the great thing about the Starbucks was that it was a short. And this was a great call for me because a lot of traders, I think, thought it was a long. Now, why might people have thought this was long? It gapped down. That's true. But it gapped down into support. Okay. It did gap down on the earnings, but it gapped into support. This is a 200 period moving average. This green line is the 50. But I have a method to determine, it's a checklist, it's a rating system that to determine that this is not a long, that in fact it's a short. And this had a huge day. You can see the big bar. So here was the trade. Stock dropped, fell, rallied. Here's the short. And I want to show you this here because this is amazing because this retested the high and almost went over the high. And this is here where people, a lot of traders probably thought Starbucks was a buy into support, but I was short in it and it dropped and broke and it actually fell and it went to the dream target. I didn't even hold this all the way down because I was also into Microsoft, but this had a massive move in it. And this is one of the things I do so well because a lot of traders probably thought Starbucks was a long and lost money, but I didn't. I made money, and it was a huge short, actually. And here's the move. Again, you take the trade, and you're out in 15 minutes, 10 minutes, 5 minutes, wherever you want to be out. But you could have held this longer. Price of the short is 58.84. Stop is 59.15. Risk is 31 cents. So in 1,700 shares, again, I'm using a risk that you would need to make 100 grand a year, 527. First target exit was 58. Again, I did not hold this all the way down, but I'll tell you, this went to $57. This went to $57 in the day. And I didn't hold this because I was in the Microsoft. I did hold the Microsoft, but I ended up having two good trades, but I could have held them both. It was a beautiful Friday. But if you did, you could have made $3,000. $3,000, risking only $527 in this, all from this entry. And this kind of thing here is exactly what I'm talking about, going back to the daily, that makes the difference. And there were so many gaps on Friday. There were so many gaps on Friday that you could have picked and traded, and I picked the best two ones. And the way that I'm able to do that is because I'm trading for 8 years. I only trade my one system. I have a rating system that tells me which ones are the best, and it told me that the best shorts were Starbucks and Microsoft, and they absolutely were. And they both went to the dream targets. And here I have the hourly rate for Starbucks is, if you know, $1,400 an hour. Again, who makes this kind of money? Actually, I shouldn't say I don't know anyone that makes this kind of money. I was just going to say I don't. I do. I know someone that's a partner in an accounting firm in New York that makes this kind of money. But he's the only one I know. And I know a lot of people in the city. A lot of people in the city make a lot of money. This is a rare amount of money to make per hour. And the great thing is, you know, you don't have to work 60 hours a week. All you have to do is find a couple of these a week. That's it. And you don't even need to do it 5 days a week. I mean, you could say, I'm only going to trade 4 days a week. I'm going to have a three-day weekend. Mondays are the slowest days of the week. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursdays are the busiest. And Fridays are up in the air. You never know what you're going to get in a Friday. But ultimately, it is just about finding the absolute best one to trade. Oh, here it is. This is blown up. And you can kind of see here the big, big fat bar. And one of the reasons this went so good and so big and passed the number was because of the fact that some traders were trying to buy it. And it was never long. It was a short. Okay? So this is what I look for every day. And here you have, again, this, and I just want to show you, it's blown up, that people are trying to buy this in here. These green candlesticks signify buying, but it's not institutional buying. This is where the institution's making the move. The move that follows through, which is the sell-off of the price dropping when it sells off hard, and it drops in this direction. The greens are not in control. The reds are in control here, okay? So the bears are in control. The bulls are not in control. You might not have known that, though, in the first six bars here, but I did. How did I know who was in control before I saw 17 red bars to short it before the 17 red bars happen? Is because of the gap. It's because of the gap. It's because of the gap. And I see the gap in the pre-market. Or like tonight, I see gaps in the post-market. And I rate the gap using a rating system. And that's how I know. And that's what's genius about my system. To be in a short like this, when there's all these green bars, short a stock with a stop right here and not get taken out, okay? And this is what you'll learn how to do from me. So you get this kind of push and the momentum. But honestly, if you want to be good in the market, you have to be consistent with your strategy. Now, Paul's going to jump on the mic and talk about his trades this week just really quickly. Are you ready, Paul?
Hey everybody, sound check. Someone on the camera here looks like to me. Let me try again. Here we go. How's that? Sound check, everybody. How's the sound? You guys hear me okay? I'm gonna be here probably about 10 minutes or so. Give me a little rest. Hopefully I'm not too loud because Melissa, as you know, is a little under the weather there, but she sounded just great. So I'm gonna go on and just go over a couple things. This first slide here I want to talk about. Is the common sense says you need an event in the stock for it to react. One of the things that I've said, you know, I've been trading for 7 years. One of the things I've said a lot is that for most traders who believe that the market is a random event, a random walk, I tend to agree with them. Most things that most people do, they are just throwing darts at a board. And the reason is because they don't have a common sense strategy. What we need to do, and what Melissa's talked about today, was finding a specific concept where there are going to be odds in your favor because something has happened where there's a clear direction. Most people who don't have that working for them either don't know what direction to play something, or they maybe have the right direction, but have you ever played something to the long side, but then maybe it went up, but you weren't in the trade because it was so jumpy and so jittery? I'm going to show you a couple charts in a minute. From the trade I did yesterday, where you can just see what we call that power, the power money coming in. I nicknamed a long time ago a power trend. We'll take a look at that. So that is what is critical, and that is what you get the advantage of in gaps. And for a long, long time, this has been the case. I mean, since the beginning of market trading and the fact that the market is closed overnight, it creates this event when the market is closed and when it's open. You get this rush that happens because the price opens at a different spot from where it closed, and it forces people to enter and exit positions. So when an event occurs, you're looking to read the side of the power money. When you find it, it will help you choose the stock to trade in the direction of the event. What made a gap? Did power money buy it, sell it? What's the power money doing? I want to also emphasize, too, because I know a lot of times during these events, people get confused. When we are talking about playing gaps, just to make it perfectly clear, we're talking about what to do with the chart after a gap. So we're never, ever talking about going out there and predicting what's going to happen before the event. Is everybody clear about that? Okay, everybody clear? We're not, because that is just, there's no way to do that. There's just no way to do that, period. So we're looking at after an event happens, and typically it's an earnings announcement, and the stock reacts to it, that forces people to have to do things. And that includes big money. You know, a lot of people say, well, if the stock gaps down a lot, okay, well, maybe little traders are getting scared out of it, but big traders, big funds don't have to. I don't know if you know or not, but it's actually not true at all. As a matter of fact, most funds have rules that they can't hold a stock that's down a certain amount. So this is why lots of times you'll have hundreds of thousands, millions of shares being sold over a morning, a day, 2 days, because that particular institution has to get rid of that stock. And when you see this event happen, it's just like riding a wave, where you don't have to fight the choppy water, you're simply riding the surface, which makes it really nice. Read the story of power, money. Read what the story of power is telling you. How do you do this? Only one way, reading price. If you are in a stock that is falling, I don't care if this is over minutes or it's over days or whatever it is, but it's falling because money keeps coming in and selling the stock. Do you really care if somebody upgrades the stock? Do you really care if the CEO comes on and says, oh, things are doing great, don't worry about it, everything's just fine? Do you really care if they come out and say, oh, we're upping our earnings for the next time? What you have to follow is not what people are saying is happening. You need to follow what is happening. And that's reflected in price. Always, always, always. People use a lot of excuses to try and avoid reading price, such as indicators and listening to news and all kinds of things. We like news events that create gaps, but we really don't care what was said at the news event. Never, ever do we get involved with trying to understand what was said. A stock is falling like crazy. Take a look at MYL. This is a daily chart of MYL. This is a trade I did yesterday. This borrows from yesterday. This happened and price is being sold. Do we know or care? That earnings might have been a good statement for all we know. Don't care. Don't know. I never look at it. Don't care at all. What I care about is when it opens, does this daily chart tell me, does it give me a clue, an indication which way the power of money is going, long or short? And in this chart, yes, it very much gave me an indication short. I only looked at this chart as a short. Anybody in the room with me yesterday knew I was looking at this as a short from the get-go, and that's all it was. Now, this is the daily chart. You can see right here, a gap down from here to here. I'm going to flip down now and take a look at the I'm actually showing you a five-minute chart. There's the daily bar. I'm going to show you a five-minute chart because this trade took a little longer to get going. It was entered right around 10 o'clock. A lot of times the plays we do actually play out by 10 o'clock. Now, you can see in here, you see this first bar? I wish Melissa was doing this slide because she could do the sound effect for what this is. But this is one of the things we talked about that's typical for the stocks. This is a swoosh bar. And this is something you actually could have gotten in. Now, I did not enter this right at the open. But shortly after open, this could have been entered, and that move could have been captured. But I actually came in after this rally came back, and the stock started to weaken again. And what happens is, folks, you see that initial surge down, the power money coming in, and then you have to see how people react to that. Was that really the power money? Was it just a handful of traders without a lot of volume going on? But what happens is, as it tries to rally back, you see here comes the power money. Boom. And look at this. Look at this stock. I mean, this is just simply a big, big, big seller. Can you just picture this up here? Can you just picture? I can't draw on here. But can you picture just like this big person up here with just like this huge pickup truck of stock? And every time people say, I want to buy this, he just says, go ahead, you idiot. Go ahead. Buy all you want. Here's some more stock for you. Here's more stock. Here's 100,000 shares. Here's 200,000 shares. Take all you want because I have a truckload that I have to get rid of over the next 2 days. And that's exactly what's happening here. And these are these powerful trends that you see, and you just ride this out. So this stock here was just a beautiful play for this. I actually got a target one right here that was trailed when the green bar happened, and the second target actually was picked right there at 44.30. So this is, you know, just a really nice play from yesterday. And again, typically, you know, I'm doing one or two things. Usually only two symbols. Sometimes I'll replay something that doesn't work the first time or take a partial risk on or something. This was Monday. I did two stock plays that one worked great. One worked break even. And one also was a play in the market that made money as well, too. So here are the numbers on it. It was a 22-cent risk. With the 2,500 shares giving a $550 risk, being 1950, about 3.5 to 1 overall. Okay, so that's the play on that, and it just, you know, the beautiful chart. And these, notice these plays guys, from Melissa. And I, these are from, I see you, Melissa. I talk faster. These plays are from the last couple of days. They're from the last, you know, these are not going back to the great play from July of 1927. These are just what we do every day. This is what we do every day. And the day before that, again, it's hard to get slides in here from today. Melissa's even out today, but this is max, and this is from the day before, and this is a long. Now, here we have the power money going the other way, and this is not a huge trade. This simply was a stock. This is the daily chart. You can see where the gap went on the daily chart, and then coming down on the intraday chart. This stock initially, now keep in mind, this is all above the prior day. This is where it closed. This is all above the prior day. And you're not sure right in here, but for this particular trade, there's a bullish bias on it. And then at some point, the money came in and straightened out the situation. You can see, can you see when the buyers took control? Can you see when the big power money stepped up to the plate? You can see this, right? Nobody's in control. And all of a sudden, boom, look at it settle down right there. Bam, bam, bam. That's where I got in. Bam, 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 bam. What's the top of the day? Back to the high of the day. And again, this is just a 1.5 risk reward trade, about 780 on 495. But nevertheless, you know, this all happened in the span of a half hour or so. So nice little trade overall. I'm going to let Melissa jump back in on this slide. But she's going to talk to you about some of the great benefits of this, or the fact that you can get going immediately with this. You can do it full time, part time. You can do it right from your house, and it's just a great profession to be in. So, Melissa got a little break there. I'll say goodnight to you guys, and here's Melissa to finish up. Don't go anywhere. She's got a couple more great trades to show you, and also taking other questions you have.
Can everybody hear me? That was a good job, Paul. So, you know, one of the things that I like about trading, like I said earlier, is that you can work from home. You know, I live in the Northeast and we have snow. And for example, like I'm sick the last couple of days and, you know, feeling under the weather. If I had to go to work to actually, you know, make money, I would have had to take sick days off and, you know, and it's nice to work from home. So it's a really, really nice income. And it's a nice job and it's a nice setup if you can teach yourself how to do it from home, get a computer, open a brokerage account, take a class like mine, and just do it. I mean, obviously it takes all of these things lined up in a row, but if you have a plan of action, you can put it together and it's not like it takes a whole lot of time. So does anyone have any questions before I go any further about anything else that anyone wants to say? Oh, thanks, Jeff. Are you sick too? Well, one of the things I want to talk about is, again, this idea of going back to pinpointing the quality trades. As Paul was saying, he had two nice calls in there. You've got to find the good ones every day. I think it's very easy to make money in the market if you can find good trades. And the days that I don't, then I just don't trade. And the days that I do something, if it doesn't work, someone asked me that question earlier, you know, what do? Well, you can take something else, but you know what? You could just stop. It would be very, very difficult to get to a point where you lose out of control if you were taking multiple trades all day long. The idea of only taking one trade a day actually is a great idea. And for the most part, it is what I do. Now, I'm not saying every once in a while I don't do a retake in something, but for the most part, I usually do like to take one trade a day. So I've devised a rating system. It's a 26-point rating system that tells you what stock to trade each day. And that's how I found Starbucks. That's how I found the Microsoft. And that's how Paul found the ones that he did too. And I don't always hold every trade to the target. I try to, I like to, but you know, I showed you I got out of the Starbucks early, but I am trying to get a move in something, a dollar, 50 cents, 75 cents, $2, whatever. And this is what I teach. So it's a 26-point professional Golden Gap rating system. That is my class. And it teaches you how to find which stock to trade. And then it also teaches you how to enter the trade and exit the trade. And you can use this to trade pretty much anything in the market. You can use it for ETFs. You can use it for stocks. You can use it for the QQQs, for the SPY, like I said. It's about longevity and consistency. And whether you want to do it for day trading or you want to do it for swing trading or option trading, you can use it for any one of these things. And like I said, I prefer to short, but you can use it to go long if you want to. But you've got to have the consistent results if you want to see the longevity in the market. Otherwise, you're back and forth with lots of different things. And so for me, it's really just about the focus. That's how you make it. And a lot of people say, well, what is possible, Melissa, and what is far-fetched? I think that anything is possible, to be honest with you. And once I started doing options this year, I really believe that really anything is possible, meaning that you could risk a small amount of money and make a lot of money in the market. But if you want to be realistic and you're just starting out, I think you take the money that you have, risk what you can afford, you follow the system, and you make money. And whatever amount of money that is, it's more money than you had yesterday. And that's how I look at it. Some people out there make claims that are very that are very far-fetched for people that are new to the markets. I don't do that to people. You can really make six figures a year, your first year out of the gate doing my class, if you're in the room with me. You can. I mean, it really doesn't come down to that much per week if you look at it. You've got to have the ability to take the trains, to have an account to do it, and to take the risk of $400 or $500 a train, but it certainly is possible. And I'm doing these things and talking to people and helping people and mentoring them because I want people to do well. And I'm not making far-fetched claims of making, you know, ridiculous amounts of money right away with small amounts of money for people to only get disappointed. I don't want you to be disappointed by the market. I want you to feel excited about the market and motivated about the market. It's the way that I feel about the market every day. Like right now, I'm excited about a trade that I know I'm going to do tomorrow in the market. Do I know if it's going to work or not? No. You never know until the market opens. But I feel excited and motivated knowing that I know what to watch and knowing that I have a good gap. And so you have to kind of balance your goals and what is realistic for where you're at right now without being far-fetched. It's kind of like under-promising and over-delivery. And that's what I'm trying to do with people and saying, listen, you can do this, but be realistic with the amount of money that you have right now, this second, because the most important thing is learning. And that's really how I feel about it. And, people come and say to me, well, how can I make it, Melissa? And what can I do? And why are some people successful and why are some not? Well, a lot of people just aren't successful because they're just not focused. They're all over the place with what they do. And they don't have a mentor. So I do mentor people in the trading room. And I think that that is very important. Someone asked earlier, you know, how many people are in the room? You can go off on your own. Maybe you only need my mentoring for a month in the room, but it helps. You don't know until you start doing it. But you definitely need a plan of action, how you're going to get there. And the strategy is the biggest thing. And this is what I teach in the class. And then the mentoring with me in the room helps. But one of the main reasons people lose money in the market is they just have no plan of action. They don't have a focus. They don't have a strategy. They don't know what to do. And they have no mentor. And then what happens is they lose money in the market. And then they lose conviction in the market altogether. And then they want to quit. And they don't want to trade. And, you know, you can't really have that type of attitude. You have to have a success attitude. You have to say, you know what, I'm going after this thing. I'm going to make it work. I know that I'm smart. I've got money for an account. I've got money to take the class. I'm going to put it together. I'm going to figure it out. People that just jump into the market and don't know what they're doing and lose money, you know, don't have as high odds of making it. Okay. Now, I'm going to actually flip through some of these slides here because we're a little behind. But the bottom line is that I teach a complete system. It's a class, and I'm actually doing a special one-week class for this coming class. It's going to be next week. Originally, I was going to do the class on the weekend. I usually do classes on the weekend, Saturdays and Sundays. I decided to do a class. I'm just going to flip through this here. I decided to do a class on the week, next week, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. It's going to be a live class where we train and then I teach. I've never done this before and I'm never going to do it again because my schedule is taking on some new projects coming into May. But I thought this would be something that would be great for my current traders and really, really helpful for new people. So my class teaches a 26-point rating system to find the best stock to trade each day. It teaches you how to enter and exit the trades. It teaches you price analysis and technical analysis on an advanced level, and it teaches you how to read support and resistance in the right direction. And it teaches you everything you need to know to make money in the market. So it is normally a two-day course. That's what I do on Saturdays and Sundays. I do it once a month. The class is live online and retakes are free. But as I said, I'm doing a special class next week. I decided to do it Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. It's an all-week live class. I'm never going to do this again. My schedule is going to be way too hectic starting May, but I thought this would be something special to do to launch into second quarter, help a lot of people, my current traders, and then also new people get ramped up and going for earnings season. And we should have a lot of gaps next week to trade as well. The class tuition price is $49.99. It's US dollars. And a lot of people can't always do it on the weekends. So this is a weekday class. I usually, like I said, always do them on the weekends. So this will be your chance to do it if you have conflicts during the Saturdays and Sundays. So if you want to sign up, you can email me at melissa@thestockswitch.com. And also, I teach a trends class. This is in June. If you want to sign up for this, I'm offering a combo special. You can do both, and you save $500. So you do the Golden Gap class in May, the trends class in June, and it would be $54.99. And so this is a nice special, too. And you get everything then for the long-term trends, which is for swing trading, really, if you want to do that. So does anyone have any questions? We're kind of down to the time here. I don't know if anyone wants to ask me anything specifically or has any questions. If you want a trial to the trading room, you can email me. It would just be Wednesday, Thursday, Friday this week. And if you want to sign up for the class, email me at melissa@thestockswitch.com. And if you want to call me, I'm starting to feel better today, so my voice should be back to normal, hopefully, by Wednesday, Thursday. So you can call me and talk if you want. And so next week should be an exciting class. And you want to watch for tomorrow. It's tomorrow Wednesday, yeah. Yeah, the FOMC minutes are tomorrow, I think they're out. And so that should be exciting. This is a chart of the SPY. We'll see what they do, how they react. Does anyone have any questions? And feel free, yeah, definitely go and read some of these testimonials. I watched the interview with Mike, and you can go subscribe to my YouTube site. It's just go to YouTube, and it's a Stock Swish on YouTube. Thanks, everyone. I apologize about my voice. But I made it through. Anyone have any questions at all? Any questions? If you do, you can always email me at melissa@thestockswish.com, or you could email Paul at paul@thestockswish.com too. And good to see some of the old faces here and some new people, too. All right, everybody. All right, thanks. Thank you, Online Trader Central. Have a good evening.